Here's the review. Know what I'm doing? Any idea? It's a white mailer. Today I'm doing the Transformers Collectors Club exclusive free figure for this year, Cyburn. Who's this guy right here? Cyburn is, of course, a repaint of the Classics Hot Rod mold. I should note, when he was packaged originally, he had a lot of plastic twist ties around him, and he came in a plastic bag for some protection. The reason these guys come in just a standard white mailer is they are the free figures. There's no need to produce the heavily expensive box art and stuff for them. He, of course, comes his own little card that has his tech specs and his bio. If you do want to read the bio, I hope you can. He's the Autobot Speedy Knight. Ha, he's a knot. I hope you can read that. I'm hoping you can. If you can, I'm sorry. I've tried my best. Okay, pause it. Pause it. It's going away. Get ready. Okay, it's gone. He comes with instructions. He has another Transformers Timelines line. Like Astro Train, Air Razor, all of those. The instructions are just like Classics Hot Rod / Rodimus. Although, I didn't know Rodimus had an attack mode. I never knew that. And basically what they're calling the attack mode, apparently it's news to me. He is a little banged up. Take this, load it up, flip this around, and I think it's kind of stuck. I guess it really could be an attack mode. I never really knew that was there, so I'm learning new things every day. Now, however, I do have a problem with the way this was packaged. Since it's just in a box that, in my opinion, is too small for it, it's left one of the ends of the spoiler really bent. I mean, you can compare it to the other side. Straight, really bent. I don't know how easy it'll be to fix that, but just be cautious. The way they've shipped it in a tiny box, that may be bent on yours. However, for comparison with Rodimus himself, there you go. I like the look of Cyburn more than Rodimus. I like this paint job. I like that blue a lot. I think it looks fantastic. Rodimus, I still like the figure, but I think I went the wrong direction, didn't I? I did. I definitely like this one's look a lot more. Even the white, it pops. Every detail's included. He's got a great Autobot logo on the top. He has the interior. Everything is still there. It's the exact same figure. As such, it has the exact same transformation. So why bother showing it on camera when I can skip right to it? And I like this guy. I do. I know other people aren't fans of the Rodimus mold in general. I think it's okay. It's not one of my favorites, but it's not one of my least favorites. It definitely has its own little charm. I really like this paint job. I'm a huge fan of the color blue, if you couldn't tell. So having a blue Rodimus, I like. He does have yellow light piping behind his head. However, his eyes are painted red, so that's kind of, you know, left pointless. Get him right there. And of course, for comparison, here he is next to Rodimus again, showing how they both look. I think I actually like this one more. This one's got a lot of detail thrown in. All of this little added area here, which you can't really see, it's got details. He has an Autobot logo on his forearm, which you may not be able to. There you go. You can kind of see it. I really like how this guy's overall paint job looks. I am a big fan of it. If they were to do a fans project set for this, I'm not going to get it, but I'd be tempted. No, it's a waste of money. However, I do think he looks great. I think he's going to be kind of hard to get. The Transformers Club may sell him in their shop. I forgot how they handle that kind of thing. I think you can buy him in their shop. I think he'll run you about $40 if you aren't a member. I don't know. eBay may have him, but if you were a member of the club already, you should have yours very soon. And I really like it. I really like how this guy looks. I'm going to be happy to put him somewhere in my overall display. Great overall figure. I'm glad to have him. Articulation, exact same as Rodimus. I don't know if you guys really want to see that, but, you know, the arms can rotate. They do get kind of caught on his wings. They can swing out to the sides, all that kind of stuff. There are bends at the elbow. He still has, well, his buzz saw, even though I still want to call it a little communications device. It's just what I want to do. I know it's meant to be a buzz saw, but communications works for me better. The head can still rotate, although it is rather stuck. The legs can go forward. The legs can go back. Only that far, which is really, ultimately, not very far at all. It's just standing up straight. So that kind of does stink. So we got to the side, nice and far, though. He does have a kind of, due to his transformation, he has kind of a, not just this movement. He can have his legs kind of bent all weird like that and make him kind of stumpy, which I'm actually kind of curious. Isn't he cute? Oh, look at him. Oh, he's adorable. I actually kind of like how that looks. I'm tempted to have one of my Rodimus displayed like that just because he's short. Anyway, that's all there. The knees can bend like before. His whole footsie has this whole movement. This one's a lot loose. This one's okay. It doesn't affect posing him at all, I don't think. And that's really about it. He does still come with his gun. Obviously, he can still fire it. Pew, pew. It's all still there. It's the same figure, just with a nice blue paint job that I love very much. I'm happy to have this guy in my collection. And kind of makes being a member of the club worth it to get something that looks like this. So yeah, if you like him, check out the Transformers Collectors Club store. They may have them in stock. They may list them later once they get all their stock mailed out. I don't know how they do it, whatever. But I would say pick it up. Looks great. Hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.